to welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Double Trouble. And of course, if we're going to do it, we're going to do it the right way. We do have Big Trill with us. Man has finally come back from Nigeria.
Like, I've been here, bro.
I don't know if I should call him Oga. I don't know. Nah, what up, though?
I'm all good, man.
What's good, man? Been a minute.
Thanks for having me, bro. Been a minute.
Yo, yeah. Krim, the last time we had Trill on here, was it when he... The last time was when we were on Smash, right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And he was promising us an album.
Whoa.
And Smash is how many years ago?
You gotta bring that up.
2 years.
No, Smash is like 3 years ago.
Two years, man. 1 year, no?
It's like a couple of months ago. So Chill lied to us 3 years ago. And here we are again. Yeah. Wow. New year, no album. What's up, man?
I love this thing. I'm all good, bro. I love this thing, though.
Yeah, tell us. What's been going on?
You know, flying to Nigeria and all that. Yeah. You know, record label changing a whole lot. And, you know, me getting to production. So
no, we'll talk about your production.
Yeah,
you're telling us how you're singing, you're playing the keys. We don't want to hear that, man. We'll talk about it later.
Okay.
But tell us what's been going on, man. Like we've been seeing a lot of Trill music, yeah. A lot of Trill videos.
Yeah.
A lot. I think you've put out quite a bunch of records since the last time we had a conversation.
Word.
I mean, because you have the joints with Fie, then we saw the shift when
thing,
when you started doing records in Nigeria, shooting out there, working with their producers, and coming to your own production. Why has the process taken longer than we expected?
Oh no, because maybe I think good things do take time though, and you know when it comes to music, you can't rush perfection, you know, and I'm a perfectionist like that, so. And you know the industry is always evolving and changing.
Yeah.
So you know you might go in studio and record this, and after 3 months as an artist, since you judge yourself even more than the fans judge you, you'd be like, no, I don't like it anymore. And
so why don't you release it after recording?
I don't know, man. Like,
why are you taking 3 months?
I don't know. Like it's like that though. So and you know when I was working on my album, and then in the middle of it, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna learn how to make music.
Yeah.
Like how to produce music, and then when I started teaching myself how to produce music, I literally trashed all the songs that I had recorded that I was going to put on the album. Yeah, so I literally just started afresh, and I was like, you know, this album is going to have my real authentic touch. Most of the songs are going to be produced by me, and that's what I've been working on basically.
So, when does this album drop?
It's supposed to be dropping this year. Trillum Come. It's supposed to be dropping this year, September.
I listened to you on a radio station.
Yeah,
I think it was earlier this year, or late last year. And you said something about you're looking at hopefully putting out a mixtape just to keep the fans.
Yeah, word.
Yeah. Are you still looking at?
Yeah. Because you know the mixtape is gonna be like pure rap and some trap music, and of course you know the album must have the rap and then the commercial rap.
Yeah.
So the mixtape is just gonna be pure Trill because you know some fans are asking for that. The old Trill back. So I got that.
We're going to get into that. In fact, let's get into it since you brought it up.
Yeah.
You recently posted something on your Facebook talking about Krim is Mr. Retweet.
Yeah.
So you were talking about the younger rappers, or you have a song for 2 weeks.
Word.
You can't be calling yourself king.
Can be.
You're keeping the same energy. This is good. This is good.
Yeah.
And why?
Because you see, I believe that titles are earned. You don't tell people what to call you. You show them what to call you.
Yeah, but then, you know, like, I agree with you.
Yeah.
But then, you know the thing about rap?
Yeah, yo.
The thing about rap, hip-hop, in its purest is... We're talking a lot of crap. We're saying
we're braggadocious. Yeah, we're braggadocious in a way.
No one here is nicer than me. But then, and people will say that 4 or 5 times, even when a guy is right next to them rapping a lot better than them.
Yeah.
They'll say it a lot.
Yeah.
And carry it on. Why did you feel the need to pull the younger rappers back and say, no, you guys are plagiarizing? You said a lot, man.
Yeah.
You said a
lot.
You said a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, cool. Now, to me is that I've grown up, of course, in the rap world. Okay?
Yes.
I've seen rappers come. We rappers are always braggadocious in a way.
Yes.
You know, I'm the best here. I'm the youngest, the best doing it.
Yeah.
But
you were very very about that.
Yeah, you're, but I never came out and called myself a rap king at some point. Never. Yeah. Never in my career.
Yeah.
Even if, you know, I know that I'm one of the best rappers in the country.
Yeah.
I never come out and be like, you know, I'm the best, I, you know, I'm the rap king.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. I've been telling people that if there's a person who maybe deserves a title like that, to me, they're two, GNL and Navio. Why? Because I'm from Rubaga.
Yeah.
And Navio is from Rubaga. You see, people like Navio and, you know, you and...
Yeah.
You have shaped the game in order for me to be here.
Yeah.
You dig?
Yeah.
But in that way, you've inspired me, or you've broken down barriers for me to be here.
Yeah.
But these kids are new. They haven't done none for the game.
Yeah.
You just have one record which is going to play for a couple of months, and then you're out here calling yourself Rap King. Like, I don't think, like...
Can you give me some examples?
Like, I don't know, man. Like
I knew Crib was going there.
No, like, Crib, I'm just
going
to say that...
I knew Crib was going there.
Yeah.
This man has a point.
Yeah.
No, I was with Trill. I was
blaming the people.
Yeah, like,
I'm putting these guys up instead of telling them.
No, but then you see, let me tell you, I always look at things from everyone's point of view.
Yeah.
I try to, right? When Trill is silent, or the Myth is silent, or Anavio is silent, or JNL is silent.
Yeah.
Who are the guys looking to?
Like,
you know, like when Nelly said, you know, Nelly said he's like finishing his album. Like when guys are actually finishing their products, and someone wants an alternative away from what's the Chidandari, right? And someone wants to listen to some hip hop. Who are they going to listen to?
I don't know, man. Like, but there's a saying that no matter how hungry a lion gets, it never feeds on grass. So you dig, like, I don't think that, you know, our fans are just going to dump down to listen to bad music just because we ain't releasing music.
It's just a club record. No, but the one thing that I was with Trill on was when you were calling guys out for plagiarizing. A lot of people did that.
Yeah, when it comes to especially rap music,
yeah,
the plagiarizing flows, beats.
Yeah, the beat thing.
Yeah, like, and they all sound the same to the point that they're literally copying each other, you know. And way back, what I liked about the rap game way back and why a rap was so hot way back is that there are rappers and we all had different styles. You have a different style, Winch has a different style, Kip had a different style, GNL, a Big Chill.
But and nowadays, and it's the same clique, but you're getting variations.
Different vibes. But nowadays, when you listen to the rappers, I swear to God, just enough, like, four rappers, they all have the same vibe, they look alike, they got colored hair, and they sound the same. And they have one drop rap. And like,
did you hear there is a new king of rap?
Oh God.
Who?
Fresh Kid.
Who's that?
Oh, the young kid.
The young kid that is making rounds. Oh, even the guy got to get a sponsor, like, you know, like,
I'm like, miss me with that, bro. Like,
angry.
Miss me with that right there.
No, back to Trill.
Like, let's not disrespect a genre that we really worked hard to get where it is, you know. But like, let's not do that.
You say that, but so as far as UG hip hop goes is concerned, you have pulled away from it.
In a way,
yeah.
But for a reason.
What's the reason?
One, I'm into production now. I'm trying to literally reroute myself and find myself.
Yeah.
And like I said, I'm working on a mixtape and an album.
Yeah.
And I've been like
I've you've been releasing records. So in my head, I'm like, so Trill has never
submitted.
A lot of people, we had Palazzo here last week, and I was like, man, I should be nominated because he did
for
the
rap
record. Yeah, he did the rap thing.
Palazzo, so. He should just steer where he's at.
So Trill has been releasing all these records, but you've never submitted your music to a hip hop
award show,
or just general award shows. Because I haven't seen your name in the conversation.
Yeah.
Do you feel like that's doing yourself a disservice?
Because
to the fans, if they're looking and they're saying, okay, Trill is fire, but Trill is not in that conversation.
Yeah.
Does it do a disservice to you?
In a way,
you
it does. Like, I don't know, man. Like, I'm complicated like that, and I'm stupid like that. Like, I don't like getting into things when I know, like,
I'm
not gonna win. I hate that. So yeah. So basically, you know, I'm looking at, you know, the best music I can release, and I'm gonna have that submitted to my records. Like, I don't want to be submitting something that even I feel like a little bit like maybe this ain't the best of me right now.
Better.
I could have done better. So I want to, like, but basically start this year. I'm on right now, because I'm. Okay. I think that my craft now is where I want it to be. I can produce anything that I want to produce. I can basically just, I feel like I'm getting there and I'm finally there.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we in same interview. I don't know if it was the interview or it was on your timeline.
Yeah.
People were asking. We're talking about you jumping into a sound that a lot of people consider West African.
Yeah.
Right. With you producing, do we hear Trill jumping into a sound that people maybe consider Ugandan? Is that a possibility?
Yeah, because you know when you listen to Gidom, I think that is a more Ugandan sound.
Yeah, that's
people call Ugandan. Yeah. But with me at the end of the day, it's just vibe, it's just music.
Yeah.
But with my production now, you know, it's like my rap, because you know. Yeah. I rap different. The big trill of Border Borders and Guns or the big trill of Struck a Money of is totally different from the big trill of Gidom. So even my beats are like that. I can make trap beats, rap beats, soul trap beats, and I can approach them in, you know, these various ways.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna be approaching beats in various ways and from different, you know, ways. And yeah, man, like me, you can never put anything past me when it comes to rap. I can literally manipulate any beat the way I want.
Have you stopped singing?
Nah, man, like, I still got my...
The man was trying to sing. The man was trying to sing. Now, yeah. I mean, you and I have known each other from for a minute.
Yeah. You gave me my first signed CD, bro. Remember,
No, but even you freestyling for me in Rouge, like, yo.
This dude that made me freestyle in the middle of the club with loud music and I was up in his ear like, yo, so you
listen to party. I was like, oh, God damn it. We're known one another for a minute. And, you know, I've seen the growth and everything. I've seen what you've been trying to do. Do you feel like, I mean, you've touched on it earlier, but then do you feel like the trill that we have, that we're going to listen to this year, do you feel like it's a better trill than the trill that we heard then?
Yeah, I think it's...
And why? Why?
I think because I'm grown now,
and
it's not all about rap now, you know, like it's more than just rap. Way before, the only thing I knew was rap. Like, you play me on a beat, I'll just rap, I'll just go off.
Yeah.
But now, you know, I know different ways to approach a beat.
Yeah.
The old trill is always going to be there because it's me, you know, that's my fabric. But now I have better ways of expressing myself because music is all about expression and better ways of executing my rap and my melodies. And, you know, yeah, basically, I'm better now, I believe.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, okay, so, I mean, yeah, we have to talk about the whole Niger thing. You have, you've been in Niger for...
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, in Niger,
what's
the response like for an artist like a Big Trill from UG, who has a different type of swag, different type of slang?
Yeah.
You know, just everything about you is, must be different from the local rapper in Nigeria. So, what has been the response for your type of music?
I think it's been dope. I'm having a steady and growing fan base in Niger.
Yeah.
You can see that online. And you can see that also Niger changed me from the trill, how I used to look and now how I look now.
Mm.
You know, I sort of picked up a few things when it comes to branding and, you know, just basically carrying yourself as an artist. So Niger taught me a whole lot, and because Niger is like a, you know, it's a bigger and better industry than ours here.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's harder to, you know, to promote down there.
Yeah.
But, you know, we're getting there. Because I'm literally like, I won't lie to you, I'm like, I think the only Ugandan musician who has been in Nigeria for a long period of time, and I'm like the only one who's really trying to push down there. Like, my music is playing on different radio stations, it's playing on different TVs. When I was down there, the only song that I heard from Uganda was this song by Sauti Sol
and Bebe Cool.
That was it. So I didn't hear no other song apart from maybe Eddie Kenzo's song once in a club.
Do you feel like, now with you saying something like that, do you feel like When some artists come out and say, yo, we really need to promote more Ugandan in Uganda, do you feel like that's something that should be happening?
Yeah, I think it's already happening. Nowadays when I go out, I find the DJs playing 80% Ugandan, which is dope. But, you know, now it's upon us artists to now look beyond the boundaries, because, you know, what good is it you being in your house and you're the man in your house, but when you walk out in the street, nobody knows you? You know, and that's how I feel how artists here operate. Like, yeah, you are number one in Uganda, but once you get out, nobody even knows your name in Ghana, no one knows your name here.
But then what if that is sufficient for someone here?
I don't think...
What if someone... You see, because I feel like that conversation
can
be had if someone is saying, I want to be known out there. There's some people. There's some people who I've had this conversation with quite a number of people.
Yeah.
And there's some people who are like, yo, I came from nothing, and I'm getting played on a Double Trouble.
Yeah.
And I'm getting paid for my shows. Yeah. I'm selling out a cricket oval.
Yeah.
I'm good.
I think that's the problem. I think that's the problem to me.
Yeah.
That's a problem.
Yeah.
As, as anybody in any aspect of life,
yeah.
And you always have to aspire to get better. You don't get comfortable and be like, me, this is it. Because life never stops, bro.
Yeah.
You dig? So if I was a kid in high school and now DJ Krim is playing four of my songs, I just can't be like, oh my God, man.
Yeah, I made it.
Yeah, DJ, like, I want to be like, oh, if DJ Krim is spinning my songs, then how do I get DJ Khaled to listen to my songs?
Yeah.
You dig? And I feel like, as artists, we should leave that, you know, getting comfortable, like, on Zentuse. You know, I can fill up cricket oval. Nobody can tell me nothing. Go try to fill up a stadium in Nigeria, because no one even, none of our artists here goes to Nigeria for a show.
For
but, you know, Nigerians keep coming here and filling up. Burna Boy is about to come here.
Yeah.
You're going to see what he's going to do. But nobody from here can go and
do the same thing.
So,
because Nigerians, they leave their side, they come here to promote their jams.
Yeah,
only
that. Yeah, true.
But us, none of our artists are called so big artists who be like, you know what, let me go for a tour.
Yeah.
I promote this
tour.
Single.
Yeah.
Because I've seen that, I've seen Diamond doing that, the manager, remember the manager coming through?
Yeah.
So I really love to see that, like, what you did.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, they say when you move out, you learn
a
lot.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I really love to see that more and more, like what Nigerians do, because they know, Nigerians know our market is stiff. Like, we are competitive.
Yeah.
Because when you look at our industry, today it's Chameleon, tomorrow it's Bebe Cool. Tomorrow, like, kids
back and forth.
You see?
Yeah.
But then when you look at their industry, you see Two Face still on top.
Wizkid
still on top. Davido still on top. Like, they have their artists, them, they're still on top. But us, you find a John Black coming into your mix. Eddie Kenzo already among the big artists, you see.
Yeah.
Like,
I think what happens is, you see, I think in Nigeria there's a system though.
Yeah.
Like I told you, that thing that they never get comfortable. So when an artist like Wizkid and Davido and Tekno and Two Face and all these big,
when they conquer and they look
when they conquer Nigeria, then now they're like, how do I get my music played in Zambia?
In South Africa.
So that means in a way the young kids can then come up. They don't suffocate the young talent.
But is that what you guys are discussing, is that because while a Wizkid or whoever could have that idea, do we then need, for them to implement it, they would need the right team behind them to help them grow further. Do you feel like while, you know, we have mad talent, do you feel like we need structures, structures in place, like more management teams?
We don't really have structures, bro.
So do you think, is that
one of the reasons why our industry is the way we are, is because we don't have structures. Right now, to me right now, the only structure that's really popping is the DJ fraternity.
Yeah.
The DJs have it together. I don't know, I don't know what you guys did bigger.
I think
the DJs
is a second artist in a week.
Together, bro. Like, the DJs have it together. There's a unity.
Yes, I think after a while, the DJs were like, yo,
I don't
have to like you.
Yeah.
But let's go.
Let's work. You understand? So now we need to get like the distributors to actually come through. We need to get the promoters to come through. The artists, because we are literally like the big stakeholders of this thing.
Yeah.
We make the music. So now we need to unite even more.
Yeah.
And we need to have now real record labels. At the end of the day, I know maybe some artists feel some type of way. Even if you're in a record label, have a team like Casper or something.
You
understand? Have a legit team.
Yeah.
But let's have these blocks and structures. And in that way, if we, you know, the structures unite, then we are a stronger force. And that's what Nigerians are about. You know, you'll see this record label, you'll see Starboy, you'll see David Music, you'll see...
And I don't think they like each other, but then they move as a unit.
They be competing with each other like crazy, I swear to God. But you see, when they meet up, they're like, what's up? But, you know, you'll see David posting Whiskey's new song. You didn't have to like him.
Yeah,
but he knows
that,
you know, it's never about the artist, about the game.
Yeah.
That's why I keep even telling these new rappers. It's never about you. Don't be thinking that because you got some fans and you get some radio spins and you think you got the hype, now it's about you. It's about the game.
Yeah.
How do you find the game and how do you live the game?
So, are you going to do a song with Fix a Maker?
I don't know.
Is that who you were talking about?
Nah. I didn't mention no name. I've never heard that boy call himself a rapper.
Fefe Busi?
I don't know. I've been thinking.
Because Fefe Busi does that all the time.
Just don't call himself
quickly. Okay, so what are we looking at? Are we looking at collabs from various artists out of the continent? I did see something, and I know, like how you said, you saw me hinting at something on my timeline. I did see something on your timeline.
Yeah.
Vector.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, oh my God. He's
I didn't see it.
Yeah. Oh, my
Back
God.
To the Viper. Oh, is that going down?
Oh, dude.
Is that going down? Because I saw that. Oh, I saw that.
Okay, I can just say,
I'm a bad guy. Yeah. I'll be paying attention.
I can just say, Victor's vocals are in.
Okay.
I got the vocals.
The vocals are in.
The vocals are in. I got the vocals, yeah.
Okay, so
that's obviously going down.
That's going down. What else can we expect?
I'm looking at more collabs with, of course, my fellow Ugandan artists.
Yeah.
You know, I've done one with Benny Gunter.
Yeah, the Benny Gunter record is hectic.
And, you know, more coming through.
Yeah.
And rappers and, you know, singers. Yeah. And I have some lined up already. And yeah, even
do we
more.
Get, do we get Nigerian. A big Trill showcase at some point? Because I know you did. I know you did Industry Night Niger.
Oh, yeah,
in Nigeria.
I did.
How did that go, first of all?
Oh, that was dope, bro. Limited. This was my first time ever performing in Nigeria, so yeah. I was nervous as hell. And then I remember the MC, yo, so this is Big Trill from Uganda.
Yeah.
He's like, okay, so he'll perform after the main act. I think it was Shay Shay performing.
Yeah.
Right. Actually, I think just play that song right now for your case, yo. I met her that night, and then you know we were freestyling, and she was like, she actually was doing dancehall, and I was like, okay, she's alright.
But now she switched up.
Yeah, she switched up. You dig? So I think my first night, you know, Shay was closing the show,
yeah.
And I told him you're gonna perform right before Shay. And then I'm
right
like, yeah, right. Yeah. And I'm like, wait. So I performed, then Shay comes on. Oh my God.
Yeah.
So I get on stage. And I remember I just had the Panda Refix as my intro, yo, and that just blew the crowd away, man.
Yeah, because it was also hot in Nigeria.
So I was like, and you know, since then, people just started asking me, where can we find your music, you know, how's Uganda? And they used to ask me, like, some other artists in Uganda, and like, me, I ain't got no bad vibes, so I recommend my people. I tell them, you know, check out Eddie Kenzo, check out Waikiki, check out Chameleon, Navio, you know, so, and I hope that when Ugandan artists go there,
they beat you up the same way.
You know, keep the same energy and keep the same love flowing. Don't be thinking that you can have the whole cake to yourself.
Yeah. Be like, Ugandan artists, I don't know.
Yeah, they're not really like me. Yeah.
I'm all you need. All right, so we're looking. Are we looking at the album? Are we looking at the album for September?
Yeah. Well, but like, let me tell you something. The thing is, I think my album is done. But now that I'm into production,
I won't lie to you.
Every day,
are you producing the whole project?
Literally, I have just a couple of beats that, like, 4 or 5 beats that have been made by different Nigerian producers. But like, I would say, like, I have enough songs for 2 albums. But that since every day, I just keep making
recording beats,
and recording, and I just pull out one, add another.
So,
one.
So where are you recording from? Back in the day, you used to record from buddies.
Yeah.
Where are you recording from?
Strike Entertainment set up a studio for me.
Oh, okay,
Bunga.
Nice.
Yeah, Bunga. So that's where I be at.
The spots we went to the other time?
Back in the day? There. No, yeah.
The one we went to?
Yeah. For real? He's been there?
When we did the video. With Shu.
That's dope.
Okay, so you're producing your stuff.
Yeah.
You're shooting every day. Yeah. What's the next single from Big Chill? What can we expect?
Right now we have a whole couple of things coming up. I have 2 other songs with Benny Gunter, because we just vibe and kept on making records. We're even just making more records. I have some solo projects. I have that collabo that, you know, that's coming through.
Yeah.
I have another collabo. So basically right now, there are so many options. I'm just going to pick out one. So
the best one,
and then just give the people the
music. Is the next record, because this one is clearly a Ugandan club, record, Ugandan club record, regional more like.
Yeah.
Are we looking at the next record being more continental? Is that what Chill is? Or are we just, I don't know. Are you
I might actually keep it a little Ugandan again.
Yeah.
You know, to consolidate again.
Yeah.
And then, maybe the next record.
Take it further.
Yeah.
All right then, ladies and gentlemen, Big Chill, how do people get in touch with you? Although they already know because you're causing drama online.
Yeah, man. So hit me up on my Twitter. That's Big Chill Kaiser, BigTrillKaiza.
Why is it that in some of your videos your name is spelled wrong?
No, my videos. Never my videos. It's just some people who just don't know how to spell
something. Like, why don't you change your name to Big?
I did say that at all.
Yo,
we had to do this interview sitting down because I'm not trying to be
like, yeah. So hit me up on my Snapchat. That's also Big Trill. Hit me up on my Facebook, Big Trill, Instagram, Big Trill, and go check out Giddim. It's on YouTube. It's on Tidal. It's on Spotify.
But
it's on
introduce Giddim so that guys can know.
Yeah, this is the fresh one from Big Trill featuring Benny Gunter, produced by Big Trill, mastered by Stain.
Nice.
It's a new one called Giddim. Check it out.
Let's go.